Hi there, my name is Zoran. Today I will talk to you about the Decorator design pattern. I will show you one practical application of the Decorator which you might even add to your actual production code. The class diagram of the Decorator, here it is. Follow the line, see who's talking to whom, and you will get the point, if that's what you are here for. But if you want to get to the bottom of it, to really understand how the Decorator works and how you can apply it in real code, stay with me, because first I will design this diagram from scratch so that you see why this diagram is like this, and second, I will implement it in .NET, in C#, and you will see even a very important optimization that is applicable to decorators, not only to the example which I will show you, but in many other cases you might encounter in practice. So stay with me, you will see the diagram and the code by the end of this video. It all begins with having just a class and a consumer who is calling a method on that class. But the problems begin when the consumer requires variation. If you need to vary the implementation of this sum operation here, one of the ways to do that is to introduce an abstraction, an abstract-based type, and make the consumer depend on the abstraction, on the base type, not on the concrete derived class which implements one sort of that operation. And then comes the implementation of the variation. In many cases, you will still want to use this concrete type, but add something to what it does. You do that by decorating it. So we introduce another concrete implementation of the abstraction, but make it contain a concrete implementation, another implementation of this same abstraction. The consumer cannot see any change. It depends on the abstraction. If it uses a decorated type, then its operation would call the contained object, take the result of its work, and do something to that result, change it in some way. You can imagine the consumer being the list. The list is using the IComparer interface in operations such as sorting or binary search. It needs a comparer to know how to sort the elements. And here comes the twist. We know how to sort the list using some concrete comparer. What if we wanted to sort it descending? Well, the list sort method does not support that. And that is where we use the decorator. We create a concrete implementation of the IComparer interface, which we might call ReverseComparer. The ReverseComparer would take any comparer, any existing comparer, and just reverse its decision when called. This is the proper example of the decorator pattern, and a very useful one, which you will really need sometimes in practice. I will now show you how you can implement this reverse comparer in C#, including one interesting practical optimization, which you will really need in some cases. Also, if you want to learn more about design patterns, I have the entire video course on that topic titled Design Patterns in .NET Made Simple at Udemy, and Udemy for Business as well. So if you want to learn a lot more about that, there is the link to this course in the description of this video, so please visit me there and watch the course. Now to the implementation. We might start from a list and use some comparer to sort it. So we sort it using the sort method. And now we want to design that reverse comparer class. I will let Copilot help me with that. Oh, this really looks good. Yes, yes, it's about what I wanted. I will just compact it a little bit, rename the parameters, and that's it. Look, when you use tools like GitHub Copilot to help you write code, you must take care of the details. This is still your code, not theirs. For example, I must accept nullable arguments here. That's what Copilot didn't get. And now we have that. This is the principal solution, the principal implementation of the decorator, which is reversing any comparer at all. Just pass that comparer there. And you see, when we need to compare X and Y, we call the other comparer and compare Y to X. So we have reversed the order. That is how this comparer is working, this decorator is working. And you can start using this class right away. But I have a better idea. Look, what happens if I had one reverse comparer wrapping a common comparer, and then I wrap it into another reverse comparer? Well, the problem is that they will reverse twice. Why? Why not just remove both reverse comparers if there are two of them? That is the optimization I want to implement, but I cannot implement it through the constructor, because the constructor cannot just remove things. I'll show you one practical trick you can apply to implement logic like this. Before that, if you like this video and want to help me spread the word about this channel, please press the like button, that will be appreciated, thank you. And now, I want to create a static factory which creates an appropriate decorator for a comparer, depending on whether that comparer is already reversed or not. I will give that task to Copilot. Look at this. I want static factory class for reverse comparer. What will it do? Oh, it didn't get the optimization. I know better than this. Okay, I will type another request to Copilot, so let's see how it copes with that. Optimize to avoid wrapping other two times. Now that is better. Yes, that is what I wanted. I will accept the solution. And now you can see the idea here. If the comparer is already in reverse, then dig the inner comparer and return that from this factory. Only if it is some other kind of a comparer, then wrap it into the reverse comparer and return that. Of course, the problem is that the other is not accessible here, but since it is already a read-only field, we can just turn it into internal, and within this library, it will be accessible to the class below. There is one more possibility here, which comes with C# 11. You can make the entire concrete implementation accessible, visible only inside this file. There's the file access modifier applicable to types, which is new in C# 11. The type declared with file access is only visible inside this file, so you can make the field public. Static factory below will see it, will have access both to the class and its field, but nobody outside this file will see it. I think this implementation with file access is an overkill. I wouldn't use it here, but I just wanted to show you what possibility exists. Maybe you will find a proper use for it someday. How do we use this? We get to the place where we were sorting the list. Now we can sort it in reverse order, very easily. Listen, the best design you can ever make is the one that requires only a single short call at the calling site. The caller here is trivial, and it is using a fairly complex logic behind this single word, reverse. But look, if we applied reversing twice, for example, you might receive a comparer from the outside, and it could already be reversed, but you need to reverse it now. You don't know that it is already reversed, you just apply a single reverse to it, but inside that will be two reverse calls, compound calls. Well, the factory function reverse will remove both and substitute it with nothing. If by any chance you called it three times in a row, that will be equivalent to only one call. This reverse comparer, there are indications that it might even be added to .NET one day. It's not there yet. So if you need to reverse the sorting order today, you will just write these 5, 6, 7 lines of code and make your own reverse comparer and use it in sorting. Thank you for being with me. Watch other videos on my channel and see you next time.